Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. So yeah, as I said at the end of the last episode, I had to play this all over again because I forgot to save for about an hour and a half. But I did it and came back and I took the liberty of figuring out this puzzle because you have to do the levers in a certain order. It'd be kind of boring to see me fail over and over again because every time these monsters come. So what you're supposed to do, and this is not from a walkthrough, this is me figuring it out and getting through. So there's a middle lever first. It doesn't move. So it's the gate lever first then. Oh, am I supposed to look at this first? I could have sworn it moved for me before doing that. Okay. Alright, we have to go over here. Alright, so I just remembered it wrong. We have to press this one first. And then we have to fight monsters. Maybe I should have slept at the inn. All negative effects except poison and sleep. Maybe we'll use that. Mint candy. So what? Okay. I guess we can only use that in battle. Yeah. Well, you should be able to see everything. So is it under a different... I'm surprised we don't have anything that gives back just magic points. Only throw it at monsters. Maybe we'll throw some of these at the monsters. Wow. We need stuff to give us magic points. What if we open the gate and then we go rest? Let's put Smog B to sleep. And we'll attack Mad Eye B. And we'll use some special attacks. Shining Arrow. Good, we did it before we put them to sleep. Soften them up a little bit. Charge dog! We don't need that spell now. Continue attacking Mad-Eye B. Rhythm of the Broccoli Bee. Oh, our dog needs some healing. Don't hit the dog. Hey! Don't hit the dog. Let's all go for A. Except you need to heal yourself. I'm gonna save McBain's special attack for next time. That last battle was horrible. Last time we all got paralyzed. Except, well, we were too paralyzed, too unconscious. Something like that. It was pretty bad. She doesn't even want to fight you. She wants to fight the other one. Okay, now the middle one. That didn't happen like that. I had to pull other levers before. Didn't we? So all we have to do is pull the middle lever? I swear I had to come back and pull two others last time. Is it random or something? So weird. Oh, I'm gonna save though. So it was like a quick save thing or something. Oh! No, that's right, there's this one. Okay. So we have to press the right lever next? Or we're supposed to pull that lever? I think we're supposed to pull that lever that I just ran away from, but let me just try this. No, yeah, we have to press that one. Or pull that one. Right, and then we have to fight him again. Okay. This is not a walkthrough. Just want to reiterate that. I do not do walkthroughs. A lot of people think I do. Alright, so at least we saved ourselves past that one fight. Oh, we can't access? Well, that's Forte, though. Why am I in Forte? Even here, though. Oh, here we go. Wait, wrong person. I feel like it's been a long time since I've done that outside of combat. They come back. They come back and we pull the right one. He might actually have a chance to cast this time. Rock Crash! Okay. Sleeping. All our finishing moves have been used. Yes. One enemy down. Mad Eye. It's a 51. Yeah, I'm not sure which one's tougher. I'm trying to put the other smog to sleep just so it's easy. We know both smogs are sleeping. We'll fight C. Heal Forte. Luna doesn't usually go that fast, or that soon. Alright, sleeping smog. We're attacking C, I think? Yeah. One waking enemy left. McBean. Yay! Now don't attack two different ones. Okay, good. So we can just focus on that one. See, even though she was attacking Smog B, she changed to A. Oh, heal self. Yeah. Save these finishing moves for the next fight. I think you'll come back here one more time. For leveling up next time. Okay, so now we do the right lever. Oops. Yeah, that sign isn't very helpful. It just says don't use the same lever. It doesn't say, well, there's a certain order to the levers. Don't use the same lever. It's weird putting the lever in the ground like that. We have to walk around it. Okay, so now we pull this one. Sorry, I misremembered that. So now we have to go back and pull the left lever. There's gonna be monsters again. Checking if anyone needs healing. Seem to be okay. What's with the sweat? It's the same monsters. We had question mark before, and now we have sweat. Okay, again, just trying to put Smog B to sleep. We're gonna interrupt, though, so we might mess that up. Jump rush. Before we put you to sleep, we'll bash you. Okay, never mind, we don't need to put that one to sleep. Shining arrow. Good thing it's not friendly fire. Charge dog. But does McBain still get to go? That's my question. Wow. That was great. Yeah, we interrupt McBain so he didn't get to go. So it's better to interrupt the enemies. Nice! Leveling up to 17. Everyone. And a little buffer. Okay, so now we pull the left lever. Now I don't know what's beyond all this. Like, I haven't gone past that. Hopefully we don't have to do any... Hopefully this is not a fourth gate. I assume three levers, three gates, right? You can't use the same one twice. That's the only help we had. So I'm just gonna save here. I'm gonna see if we can run back and sleep to get Forte and Jan and Rick's magic points back up. Because I don't know if we're going to need that. Like, for all I know, the resonant stone or whatever we're looking for is going to be right there, or it's going to be a huge dungeon with more monsters. We just found our way in. So, I saved there just in case we don't have to do everything again. Do you have stuff that... See if they have anything that... Oh, yeah. Wait. We don't have leash bottle? We do. Oh. Damn it. I was looking at items. Well, it's really stupid, but since we're back here, let's rest. I hardly ever rest. Not in this installment. Let's see if everything's the same way we left it. No one came back and closed these doors again. Okay. Alright, here's the third gate. Uh-huh. Forte and his friends obtained the Resonant Stone of Targon. What kind of power does this have? Asked Forte. It's carved Targon, says McBain. It has an effect of enhancing the power of concentration. Concretely speaking, it is a supplemental effect, such as making a powerful attack be released easier. When we get in the crunch, it'll be very helpful. The chest is empty. Alright, so helpful. Alright. Resonant stone, not orb. This cures negative effects. Reveals invisible monsters. Water attack spell. Healing spells. Earth attack. Right, that's the sleep thing. Defense power. Raises ally evade rate. Bind freezes enemies' movement. And increases chance of critical hits. Resonant stone found in a cave near a lake. Wow. Equipment. Unequip. Oh, he has all these equipped. So, how do we equip these? It's a special button we're supposed to push or something. At least just change it. Yes, there they are. How do we equip them? Oh, you can only have four. Okay. Life, Earth, and Technique. Okay. Jan and Rick can't have Resonance Stones. Okay. So Leah, he only has Water. Let's equip Target for the critical hits. And for Una, she has Life, Earth, and Technique. So I'll let McBain have a third one of Bind. Sweet. I'm gonna save. Done. Now we just leave, and then what do? Oh, we have to get the key back to what's his name at the inn. whose name is either Wine or a regular name starting Wiley. His name is either Wiley or Wine. McBain says, it'll be dangerous if a traveler wanders off in here, so lock the door back up. We need to go and return the key, too, says Una. Hmm. The cat wasn't in our way, no. Just wanted to see what would happen if we try to go in. Palman says, huh? Forte whispering, didn't we meet him back in Polka? He's the captain of the numerous army, says Una. How may I help you, young man? Asked McBain. Have I met you all somewhere before? It must be just your imagination. Is it so? It is so. There they go. Let's see what these people have to say. Sleeping. This lake is also the best fishing spot, but the swamp in the south of Kavaro is pretty good too. Big black catfish live there. They're worth catching. Oh really? Says McBean. The lightning strikes in the swamp. Not very many people go there, so it's a good out-of-the-way place. Even I wouldn't go to the east of the swamp, because enormous lightning hits there. I hate swamps and games. I guess we're destined to go there, though. Alright, get the guy his key back. Inn's Winery. Welcome back. Here's the key, says Una. Thank you very much. Forte and his friends return shrine key to the inn owner. How did it go? Did you find anything? McBain says, well, as someone who engages in music, we had a sacred feeling of being touched by the sign of a great musician's presence. Good for you. Mister, what did the people want who just came out? Forte asked. You mean the guy named Palman? He said they were looking for Aria. Looking for Aria, says Una. He also said he has something important to say to... I told him I didn't know her whereabouts, then he looked very disappointed. Huh. I told Mr. Palman that Miss Aria had stayed here for a few days and checked out today. Do you think it was a bad idea to tell him the truth? No, being honest is the best thing, says McBean. Unless you're being stalked by him, you never know. I'm more interested in what he intends to do after he finds her. Yeah, exactly, McBean. Why did the soldiers need Miss Aria? Says Winery or Wiley. She has the perfect singing voice. I guess we're leaving? Grandpa, what's next? It's not like I'm not anxious about that girl named Aria, but it's not something we can stick our nose into very far. Let's head straight to Kavaro. Then we can see the International Theater, says Forte. Una says, I'm so excited. Yeah, excited. Kavaro is west. Monster's still afraid. I mean, we leveled up again. I wonder if we're ever gonna have to grind to get some levels. As it is, it's like we're over-leveled perpetually. And that's not me doing anything. I haven't been grinding off-screen or anything. I don't think these creatures would give us much experience. In EverQuest terms, they're green to us. They're a green con. I like that, with the drums. Very dramatic. Get across there. Just looking around for any chests or special things. Oh, there's no sign even that they were close, that we were close. Wow, says Una. Forte is speechless. What's wrong, Forte? Says McBean. You're so surprised that you're speechless? I thought both Bozerl and Enverin were big cities, but this town's size is not even comparable. What are those things that are suspended above the town? Asks Una. That is called the Elevated Waterway. It's another significant architecture of Kavaro, along with the International Theater. They are drawing the water from the mountain range in the north via the Grim Bridge. Oh yeah, the Grim Bridge. Thanks to it, the citizens of Kavaro can drink cold and delicious water even in the summer. They built such a facility just to drink cold water, says Una. It sounds very rich, Forte says. McBain says, even so, it's not as vulgar as Rish's mansion. The citizens of Kavaro have been endeavoring to make this city more beautiful and livable throughout the long history. So to speak, the whole city is the work of art. I see, says Forte. Kavaro is the city of art in that sense as well. Una says, Mayor DeMille and Miss Maritos, who we met at Riatom Island, live here, right? McBain says, we took a lot of side trips, so they should have already come back. Yeah, we side trips and backtracking trips. Forte says, since Mr. DeMille is the mayor, he should be in the city hall. In the meantime, let's go see him to say hi, says McBain. Hey, I want to do it under my own power. I'm going to get lost. I want to start from the beginning of the city. free will. Rosaria says, this is the Kavaro City Hall, which assures you the bright future of municipality. We are the McBain Company, says McBain. We met Mayor DeMille at the party on Riatom Island. We stopped by to greet him. Is he here? Oh, you're the McBain Company. I've heard about you from Mayor. You beat Kavaro's two biggest musicians at the audition. Besides, you had a scuffle against the pirates too, right? I feel like we are celebrities a little, says McBain. I'm sure Mayor will be happy to see you. Mayor DeMille is in the mayor's office in the back. Please come in. Forte says, Mayor, long time no see. Hasn't been that long. Una says, hello. Oh, the McBain Company. Thank you for what you did at the party on Riatom Island. You're back very fast, says McBain. We did sidetracks and backtracks, remember? I got a ride from the Planetos 2 to the nearest seashore. That made things easier. Did you get to meet Captain Thomas, says Forte? Well, I couldn't meet him after all. I did meet the young sub-leader named Ruka, though. It looks like Captain Thomas was not on board. That's too bad, says Forte. Anyway, I'm glad to see you well, says McBain. Are you still having a fight with the female president of Maritos Group as usual? Well, to tell you the truth, we got along so well on the way home by the Planetos 2, and we talked passionately about Kavaro's future. People often say that you will feel more united if you go through the same turmoil. I think that's the reason why. We are talking about planning some event together. In our first attempt, we decided to hold the concert of Mr. Balthazar and Diva Wendy together. Of course, all the performers of Kavaro will perform as well. This is a dream joint performance which wouldn't have been realized if we were still not getting along with each other. People in the town are so happy. Wow, the plan sounds great, says Una. Why don't you stay here for a while and join our special concert? Oh no, says McBean. We're still in training. We're not worthy of playing on the big stage here. Yeah, you are. We beat everybody. But since we are here in the City of Art, we are planning to fully enjoy Kavaro and feel the fresh air. Sounds good, says the mayor. Feel free to come visit me anytime you need me. Thank you. I'm going to call in an episode here, and we're going to start looking around in Kavaro. I think we'll look around this building, and we'll backtrack to the beginning and start from there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.